on this episode of Crappie Kings TV.
We're back in Chatham, Mississippi, at Baiting Thangs, fishing on Lake Washington for big crappie.
I get here, it's jacket, insulated pants, long underwear, gloves all day. What's up with that?
You know, Karl called, he's wanting to come south, get out of that cold up in Canada. I picked him up in Memphis, headed to Lake Washington in Mississippi. We met some more cold weather down there.
Well, we're out here on Lake Washington. It's 32 degrees right now this morning. We're gonna start out fishing about 30 inches deep, probably 6 or 8 foot of water.
Now, you know Tim knows how to find crappie. It doesn't matter where it is in the United States. So I'm relying on him. Remember, I'm the co-captain. I'm watching the rods, making sure the line's not jumping up, going to the right, going to the left.
We're gonna get out here and see if we can find some of these pre-spawn big females that are out here just kind of hanging out, waiting for the water temperature to warm up.
The boy, Tip. Lake Washington crappie. Tell mama to come on over, bite the left side of the boat, okay? Go on, bye.
Monster crappie, boys and girls. That dude hit like he weighed 15 pounds.
Everything else stops. All I'm looking at is that pole and a big crappie.
Looks like a good one. You're live at Baiting Thangs here on Lake Washington in Chatham, Mississippi.
It's a cornmeal breading that we mix up ourselves. And here's the reason you should come to Fat Baby's Catfish House.
Hey, welcome. We're back in Chatham, Mississippi at Baiting Thangs, fishing on Lake Washington for big crappie. This week on Crappie Kings Television, hopefully Tim and I are gonna get that elusive 3, 7, 3, 5, maybe even a 4 pound crappie. Because you know what? This lake has the potential for those size crappie that you and I can both catch. Let's go do it. It's foggy, it's cold, but I wanna catch crappie.
You know, Karl called, he's wanting to come south, get out of that cold up in Canada. I picked him up in Memphis, headed to Lake Washington in Mississippi. We met some more cold weather down there. We got there, temperatures were cold, we were bundled up, wearing gloves, hats, toboggans.
It's 32 degrees right now this morning. We're gonna start out fishing about 30 inches deep, probably 6 or 8 foot of water.
First week of March, usually by now it's 60, 70 degrees, beautiful sun, you name it. Week before, the guys are just smashing crappie. I get here, it's jacket, insulated pants, long underwear, gloves all day. What's up with that?
Water temperature is 45 degrees. A week ago we was here, it was 55. So, you know, it's put them in a holding pattern. They should be out here in a little bit deeper water, so that's where we're gonna give them a try. And hopefully have a good day.
Now, you know Tim knows how to find crappie. It doesn't matter where it is in the United States. So I'm relying on him. Remember, I'm the co-captain. I'm watching the rods, making sure the line's not jumping up, going to the right, going to the left.
Today we're gonna use B&M Captain Coleman Minnow Rigs, and we're gonna mix it up with some Strike King tubes and maybe some Rage Tail grubs on some 1/8 ounce and 1/4 ounce jig heads, just to try to find out what the bite is, what they're looking for, if they're wanting something a little bit smaller like a minnow or something larger. Take us a couple hours to figure that out. Once we get dialed in, we'll probably switch all to one bait, either minnows or jigs, so we'll see how they go.
Netter, Tim?
Yeah.
Atta boy, Tim. Lake Washington crappie. Oh, that's a nice one, eh?
Big white, big female.
First Lake Washington fish, Tim. What do you think of that?
2 pound fish.
First live well fish of the day?
Yeah.
Can I hold it?
Nice fish.
You see what a nice guy? He lets me hold it. He caught it. First Lake Washington crappie of the year. In a box. Fat-bellied crappie. Come on.
You know, at these lakes, especially down in Mississippi, for some reason, these fish position themselves up high in the water column. We see it all the time. You know, it might be 10 foot deep. We might just be fishing 12 inches on the surface. Fish are like us. They want to be comfortable, they want to be able to breathe, and they want to be where they can get something to eat.
Oh geez, and I got this going here. Sorry, Tim.
Better grab a net.
Where are you, Tim? Where's the net? Oh, God. He's heavy. Attaboy. Attaboy, Tim.
Got him on that old Strike King 2. Red chartreuse. Look what a belly. That's a fat bottom girl there. Old fat bottom girl.
We just moved too, eh?
Pretty fish.
Yeah, man. I'm going to do the honors. You see? You fish with the right guy, you get to hold a fish too. But I promise you, sooner or later, that's going to happen. Look how thick. Look at that. Wow. We're going to let her go. We're going to take some pictures of some of these fish. Look at the backs too, how nice and thick. Just a gorgeous fish, gorgeous fish. Got a little scar on her. We're going to put her in a live well and let her go in a bit. Thank you, big girl. Making our day. The sun finally comes out, but it's still cold. And we're wondering, are they going to bite? They start biting.
Oh, looky here, baby. On a G.
Left him in, all right?
Bring him on in. Looky here.
Whoa,
come over here, brother.
You see, swing and a miss, huh? I didn't miss that one. I mean, is that the same one?
Yep.
Same one came back.
Same one nibbled on the other pole.
Grabbed, hit my little B&M one. He's just a small one. But a little female, maybe, hey?
Yeah, female.
Little female. Going back. You know what that is? My first Washington crappie that I caught, 2014. God, I love you, crappie. You ready to go back? Huh? Ready to go back? Tell mama to come on over, bite the left side of the boat, okay? Go on. Bye. Catch and release for the future. We got a 3-pounder, I'm telling you. You know where it's going? In there. I'll take some pictures. And like I promised her, like I promised the fish gods, the crappie god, I'll let him go. Please. Bite this jig and eat the jig. I'll catch you, love you, kiss you, and let you go. Let's go. Man, does it feel nice. Tim's getting them, I'm getting them. He's getting poles that are pulling to the left, pulling to the right, pulling down, you name it. Lake Washington is where it's at.
You know, under cold conditions, we had to alternate our pattern from what we normally do. We're normally trolling pretty fast. We had to slow our presentation down. You know, we had to actually get down to a slow grind and position our baits at different depths. Not real deep, but we had some maybe 30 inches on the surface and some 12 inches on the surface.
There's a lot of things in fishing that excite me. When we start catching big, fat slab crappie, the whole world stops for me because all I'm looking at is that rod. Is it going to bounce? Is it going to the left? Going to go to the right? Is it going to come up? Everything else stops. All I'm looking at is that pole and a big crappie. Looks like a good one. Looks like a good one. Attaboy, Blackley. Thank you, sir.
Look at him go. Again, old Strike King jig. They won't bite you.
Yes, sir. Look at that, eh? Crappie. White crappie. Oh, he's got it, too. Just right through the jig, around the glove, in the glove. Talk about pandemonium. That's what you got right there. Look at that. Beautiful. Beautiful. Pearl. Beautiful. Cold water crappie. Gonna go in the live well with the other couple we got. We'll let them go, take some pictures. But some of these be good for eating. You know, they're not full of eggs. Love a little fish fry. Let's put her in there. Ready to go in there? Your friends are waiting. You wanna go in? I like the way she drunk it like that. You still see a little mark on her hook. The hook went in, bang! Those are the bites you like. Go on. Cause those are the bites you rarely miss. Even if I didn't see the bite, Tim, get him! Boom, he got it good. So maybe that sun just inspired them a little bit more. It's just a trigger effect. Start biting more so we can catch them. So next time you come to Lake Washington, you are gonna catch them. Little Rosie. Oh, fingers are just frozed. Frozed. That little minnow, barely through the lips. Look how small that is. You gonna catch me a big fish or a small fish? As long as it's any fish.
Let's see. Double minnow rig, jig, jig, jig. Which one's gonna get bit? Jig's been hot, eh?
What's today?
Attaboy, Tim. Attaboy, Tim.
Jig fell out in the net.
Did it?
Yep.
Oh boy. Whoo, lordy. That's why we come to Lake Washington, huh?
Strike King strikes again.
That's the deal today. Look at that thing. Look at those fins, eh? I said it before, I say it again. Just look at that fins, man. That's where all that power is when you're swimming. Everywhere, boy. The back, big yap. Well, she's gonna join her friends for a short swim for some pictures. You made it on TV. You're on Crappie King's television, girl. Thank you, making our day. Well, as you can see, we're not catching a lot, and it's water's only like 47 degrees, but the sun's come out, we're warming up a bit, and the biggest thing with this really is focus and concentration still, and not just saying, well, bite's off, we're not getting any, go in. Tim perseveres, moves around different spots, you know, if you don't get him in 8-9 feet, moving into 7, he made a comment that if we don't get him in this 9, we're going to go a little bit deeper and try, but different depths, alter it, adapt, and you'll catch them like us on Washington or anywhere else. Crappie swim in the cold front. Let's keep going, hopefully get some more.
You know, we've altered our pattern. Finally, we're catching some good sized fish and 2+ pounds. That's what Lake Washington is known for. And that's what we started catching.
Wind just changed direction.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe I'll make them bite.
God, no. God, what a monster crappie, boys and girls. That dude hit like he weighed 15 pounds. Oh, man. What a hit. Oh, ain't that.
Your rod scream?
He ain't no giant, but my goodness, he was mad.
Oh, you good fish, man. Good fish, Tim.
Another 2+.
In the box?
2+.
Not a bad average, huh? Beautiful fish. Put him in there, keep going. Looking for more and more. Average like that, boy. Anywhere across the states, it's pretty good fishing. Even when it's slow. Ready? Go join your girlfriends.
Maxine, the strangest fish you've ever caught.
What's a pacu, P-A-C-U. It's a cousin to the man-eating piranha fish. And I thought it was a shad at first when I was fishing out on Steel Bayou on the other side of Milesville. And when I pulled him in, well, I was fighting with him because he was so feisty. And then when I finally got him in, then I got ready to take him off the hook and I noticed it had human teeth. So my stepson was with me at that time, Wayne Williams. So, and I kind of stood back and said, this fish has human teeth. So he reached down and got him out for me. And then so, and I said, that's a strange looking shad. And so we just, you know, well, we tried to keep him living, you know, cause I wanted to bring him here cause I knew my boss knew about, you know, all different types of fish. So, but he died still. And so when I bought him in the next day, so I talked to my boss, Mr. Mike Jones, and he called the wildlife fisherman people from out of Jackson. And they came down and they said that it was a pacu. And they kind of figured that someone had him as a pet and they let him out in the Steel Bayou. And I was fishing with a worm at the time and he just caught the worm and I just reeled him in. And I'm still famous for my fish today.
So you caught that right here in Mississippi?
Right here in Mississippi, on the other side of Milesville, Mississippi.
So you're somewhat of a celebrity.
Yes, I am. Yes, I am. And I'm very proud to be.
And are you going to mount it?
Oh, yes, yeah. I am. Yes, that's what I plan on. I'm going to take them home, yes, and have them mounted.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
I'm Joey Tatum. I'm the owner of Fat Baby's Catfish House in Cleveland, Mississippi. We've been in business a little over 10 years now. Started in January of 2004. We have steaks, seafood, we have fried shrimp, boiled shrimp, catfish. We also grill and blacken catfish. Our catfish is all U.S. farm-raised catfish. Comes from a local plant here in Edobina, America's Catch. The whole catfish is pretty popular. A lot of people like the bone cooked in the fish. It gives it a lot better flavor. Okay. It's kind of like steak. A lot of people prefer a T-bone or porterhouse over a ribeye. The bone makes it taste better. 7 days a week, 11 to 2:30 for lunch, and 4:30 to 10 for dinner. I'm gonna show y'all how to cook some southern fried catfish. These fillets are already prepped and ready to fry. We split them. We take a whole fillet and split it in half. When we fry them, they fry up a lot crispier and cook a little faster. It's a cornmeal breading that we mix up ourselves, our own special seasonings. We make our own hush puppies. Our mix is already made up here. Fresh cut French fries. And here's the reason you should come to Fat Baby's Catfish House.
We're here at Fat Baby's Catfish House and you're watching Crappie Kings Television.
You know, today we kind of had to change it up a little bit. The fish were real finicky, so we fished a combination of two things. We fished B&M, Captain Coleman minnow rigs, a quarter ounce, and also we used Strike King rage tail grubs and some tubes. Finally worked out toward the end.
Atta boy, Tim. The black man catches another one, as in Blackley.
He ain't no giant, he's a decent fish. Paint jig does it again.
On a pinky?
About a pound, three-quarter fish.
Oh, yeah. Box her up. All right. Yeah. Decent.
Spoke too soon. No sooner than I thought I got it all keyed in, Tim is like kicking my butt. Fish on, fish on, fish on. I'm watching my poles. Nothing's happening. Nothing. All to the left. It's incredible. When that happens, you just got to suck it up and figure, you know what? Those fish are still coming in the boat. Do I wish I caught them? Yes, but Tim's getting them. I'm still happy.
Old BGJP air dried him. He eat that jig all the way down in his gut.
Wow, flyers?
No, I can get him out. The ones that's eating now are eating good.
Too small to eat?
Another little male. No, he's a good eater.
He'll keep something to eat, eh?
You know, sometimes when you're fishing, whether you're fishing with your partner, wife, whoever, you know, sometimes one side of the boat's a little bit hotter than the others and you got hot poles on one side. Well, that happened to be the case today. Carl's side was a little bit slow.
Oh, good. Oh, it ain't big. He's just wilder than a buck.
You can scoop him up?
No, I get him.
Okay.
Man, look at him, he's wild. You're just a little feller. You shouldn't be that wild. You're just a boy. You're just a little boy. You're acting crazy. Act like you weigh 6 pounds. You don't even weigh a pound. That's a little male. Go back home, boy. What's wrong with you?
Nice fighter, eh?
He was wild. He was mad. The pole was bent all the way down in the water. But when this thing's going through the water and that minnow's swimming, a lot of times we miss the fish, but they just grab the minnow. They're just grabbing this part, and they don't ever get up on the hook. I mean, they'll pull the pole down. It looks like you got him, but when you pull him hard, you end up just pulling him off because he just got the minnow in his mouth. So you see a lot of people miss, especially on bigger fish. There's some fish right there at six foot.
Lifter, netter.
Oh, come on, you wild beast, you. Come out of there.
Oh, you got the other rod too, eh?
Yeah.
they got wild this afternoon. They just running like they weigh 10 pounds. It's a jig I just put out.
Yeah.
That's the ticket. We about figured it out, folks. It took till 2 o'clock. Nice little female.
It's another one for the basket, huh?
You stay me. Back there, I can pay me.
Yeah, I'm just, that's all I'm doing. I might as well just stand right here, like this, puppet man. Give me the fish. Give me the fish, give me the fish. Keep going, figuring it out.
You know, today was a grind. It worked out great toward the end. We got a good bunch of fish. I'm proud to say we had a good day on Lake Washington.
Overall, another great day in Old Miss on Lake Washington. Am I gonna come back? You bet I am. We caught some big fish, some good fish, and just had a great time with a good buddy once again. I love Old Miss.
A big thanks to Mike Jones of Bait and Thangs and Southern Star RV Park and Cabins on Lake Washington. Accommodation provided by Greenville Inn and Suites.
Feel that? Sun. Three little letters. S, O, wait, sorry. S, U, N.
Crappie Kings Television, presented by B&M Poles. Wherever fishing takes you, B&M has been there. Young Steels, Ford Lincoln. Power Pole, Shallow Water Anchor. Visit us at crappiekings.com.